Hey, welcome back. It is Carlos Cavallo from datingfire.com and datingadviceguru.com. You know, probably the number one thing that I get asked about is, of course, text messaging. Of course, why wouldn't I get lots of questions about that? Well, the unfortunate thing is that most women don't really understand how texting works at the foundation level with guys. You gotta know really how to make a guy want to respond to you. That's a little bit what we're gonna talk about today. We're gonna talk about some flirty text messages that make a man actually want to talk to you and text you back. And before we get rocking and rolling with this particular video, make sure you do the big three. Of course, number one, like and subscribe. Why wouldn't you? This is awesome stuff. You gotta get more. Number two, absolutely turn on the notifications, that little bell indicator next to the subscribe button, so you know when the next one comes out. And of course, if you have any questions or comments, or you just want to generally disagree or be disagreeable, leave that in the comment section below. The reality is that most of the text messages that you get online are simply not that good, with, of course, the exception of Carlos here, because I give them to you with more of a context. I'm the exception because I'm giving you more of the understanding of what makes men want to respond to texts and what we think of when we actually see the text that you send us. The big reason that you don't get very good texts online is because those sites are usually in the job of making you come back every single day and give them clicks, right? Give them more clicks, see more ads. This is what we're doing today. We're not going to be doing that. I'll give you an example. One of the texts I saw that was just incredibly bad was, "Hey stranger, what? Why would you send that?" Well, first of all, you don't want to send that. You don't want to send texts that do nothing. Number two, it sounds obvious. You're just trying to start up a conversation. That's what it sounds like to a guy, and yes, we're going to figure that out. Would a high demand woman be pinging guys trying to start up text conversations out of nowhere? No, they don't need to do that. They're getting guys texting them all the time. Yes, guys can pick up on this and we know exactly what it means. So don't do that one, okay? Another reason is too many. You don't need 130 texts. Some of these articles give you 130 lame ass texts, I'm being honest here, in the hopes that you're gonna find just one that you're willing to use. And quite honestly, you probably won't. Here's my number one flirty text rule for you. You shouldn't be spray and praying, okay? If you don't know what spray and praying is, it's basically where you have a ton of texts and you just throw them all out and you hope that somebody responds to one of them. You have to have a strategy if you want your texting to work. If you want that one special guy, well, guess what? You've got to give him what he's looking for. You got to send him something that's going to make him respond. Another flirty text rule here is that there's too much sexual bait that is being used. If you lure a guy in with the prospect of sex, that's all he's going to want from you. All you really need is one good text. You don't need 130 out there, okay? Another flirty text rule, think less about how you want him to see you and a little bit more about how you want him to think about the two of you together. Again, it's another critical difference that a lot of women don't think about. Another flirty text rule here is don't try to get into a long, deep conversation with a guy via text. It's just not going to work. It doesn't work. I'm going to tell you why it doesn't work with guys closer to the end of this video. Another flirty text rule is you want the text to start him to text you back, right? And eventually lead to getting together. That's your goal. That's your ultimate goal for texting, is to get in person with this guy. It's absolutely the most important thing. That's it, and that's where your focus should be. The truth here is that most women are looking for lists of flirty texts because they just don't know what they're doing with men. They have no idea. They have no clue. So they're just out there looking for, well, what works with guys. It's not so much the words, it's always the strategy when it comes to communicating with guys. You've got to know what it is he really wants. And I hate to say it, but you have more reason to do nothing, as in not text anything, when you have a million texts that don't do anything, right? You look at these texts and you know right away they're not gonna work, so you don't use any of them. So here are three powerful flirty texts that you can actually use with a guy. They're effective, okay? Okay, the number one text I'm gonna give you here is what I call the sweet dreams text. You want to be the last thing he thinks of before he goes to sleep, and ideally the first thing he thinks of when he gets up in the morning. You're kind of bookending his day a little bit, and you're really making sure that you're the one who's going to be on his mind. Sure, he can have other little women interfering with him, but it's important to have these two spots in his day reserved for you. So the number one text I want to give you is sweet dreams. Maybe we'll meet in one of them. That one's really good. This will plant yourself in his, they'll plant you in his mind at the end of his day, right before he's about to go to sleep. And it's more than likely gonna make him want to text you more because Well, it leaves him with kind of a cliffhanger. Nothing happens after this. And you're also the one who's ending the conversation. This is a very subtle technique that has the most effect on guys of anything you can possibly do. And that is that you don't need, you, meaning you, don't have to keep a conversation going all night long. He's used to most women trying to start up a conversation, trying too hard, and basically try. He can smell your trying on the other end of that text message. Here's another Sweet Dreams text that you can use that's very effective. Sleep tight and don't let the bed bugs bite. I might bite though if I'm excited enough. Again, very titillating, very kind of has that edge, that sexual flirty edge, but it's not overtly sexual. And that's really important too. Keep the overt sexuality out of your text messages. If you have to use that, again, what is he going to think about you? He's only ever going to think about you that way. You're never going to get a man into a relationship that way. A lot of women use this hook. It's the hook and the bait that 99% of women use these days because men have so many more options than they used to have. I'm going to talk about that again in a little bit. Let's get on to the number two text. Number two text you want to send him are any kind of text that lets him know he's the man. He's the guy that's got it going on. It basically is, yeah, it's a little bit of an ego boost text, but it's good if you do it right. Here's one you can use. Hey, good luck on that blank. And again, blank is just anything he's doing that, you know, that he wants validation for. And a guy always has something going on like that. Hey, good luck on that blank. I know you're going to crush it and look like a boss doing it too. That's a really effective one because it shows that you're on his side, you're supporting him, and it makes just plain makes him feel good. Now the number three text, this one's really good because, well, for so many different reasons. It's called the help me pick my outfit text. And yes, that's exactly what you send him. Let's say you're going out to do something. It could be a job interview. You could be going out with friends. You could be going out on a date with him. Whatever the reason is, you're going to employ him to help you pick your outfit. Even if you don't use what he says, and actually that's a good idea, is to not use whatever it is he chooses, but you're going to go through the process of picking between two items at least two times with him in the text. So it's kind of interactive. It keeps him engaged. It definitely will get him involved. So you send him a text that says simply, help me pick my outfit today or tonight or for whatever. And then attach a picture of whatever it is you're looking at that you want to wear. So it could be a dress, could be whatever, but give him just two options. Don't give him a bunch, just two, okay? And you'll do this maybe twice, you know, with dresses or with whatever, dresses and then the shoes or your outfit and then the shoes, whatever it might be. Please don't do this with yoga pants. This does not work with yoga pants. Let's step up our game, ladies. So many women are out there these days dressing in casual wear all the time. There was a time when each gender, the men and the women, would focus on their attire for the day and they would really make themselves look good. Remember those days? Remember the 50s when guys would always be dressed up in a suit? I remember looking at images of famous authors and they would be dressed up in a suit as they are typing on a typewriter. These guys had all the reason in the world to sit there in their underwear and they were wearing suits. So the lesson for you is make sure you are dressing up a little bit, putting some effort into it, okay? So when you're giving him choices, no yoga pants. And then the last text is, you finish with what? Of course, have a little bit of fun with underwear. And you can just put that underwear with a question mark and then give him two choices there. It can be the exact same underwear with different colors, you know? But that's the idea. Get him thinking in that way so that his mind, his imagination will take over from there. That's the edge of where you want to go with the sexually titillating stuff. Now remember, here's the big thing I want you to remember from today's video. Men don't really like to text women, but that's why you don't get, that's why guys drop off. That's why guys ghost and disappear, is because we get so tired of texting. So you've got to be willing to accept that and realize the number one goal for you is to get him with you in person. It's not to start a text conversation. That's not what he's there for, and that's not what you're there for too. You've got to start thinking very differently about your texting. Guys have far too much choice now. And it's too easy, way too easy for him to ignore you. You've got to be more effective and you've got to know what really gets into his head and into his heart and what makes him want you instead of some other woman. The idea here is you've got to be the highly desirable woman. You've got to be the epitome of the woman that is chased by men. You know these women. You've met them before. There's these women that have this kind of charisma with guys. They don't have to work at it. They don't have to try hard. They don't have to worry about texting guys things that make him want to respond because guys are always texting her. And as a result, she lets a few fall through the cracks because she just doesn't have enough time. Wouldn't that be the ideal situation? Well, the way you do that is learning what it is that men are thinking and what we really want from women. You can't just spray and pray. You can't just throw these texts out there randomly. You've got to be doing better than that. And that's what I teach you with my programs. In fact, I've got a program I'm going to tell you about right now that you shouldn't be looking at right now. It's called Passion Phrases. This is the way that you get men to chase you and you get them obsessed with chasing you. You have to know how to use words. All the phrases I give you in this program are usable in text. You can use them on the phone with them. You can use them when you're in person. They're the most versatile set of words you can use with a guy, and I give you all the reasons why they work and how they work and the words themselves, the exact phrases. So I basically do all the work for you. Go on over and check it out. You can go over to datingfire.com/passion. That's datingfire.com/passion. See this link right here? datingfire.com/passion. It's the perfect program to get you started on this path to understanding guys, because once you understand how to talk to guys and you see that these words really do have an effect on him and he will respond to them and it will make a difference in your relationship, when you see that, it makes your world turn differently. Your entire world changes because you know the truth. The reason most women are not succeeding is because they don't know what they should be saying and shouldn't be saying and why, so that they can choose the right words at the right time. Go on over to datingfire.com/passion. And before you run away or run on to the next Carlos video, of course, why wouldn't you want another one of these? Make sure you do the big three. Make sure you like and subscribe, because this is the thing you need, that you know this is what you're looking for. Number two, make sure you turn on notifications so you know when the next one comes out. And number three, you have any suggestions you want, like for a video, or maybe you didn't like these texts and you want to give me some of your grief, well, whatever you want to do, do that down below. Hey, this is Carlos Cavallo. As always, it's great talking to you, and I'll see you next week. Live and love with passion.